I've done plenty of videos about cassette recorders, but up until now, I've never done a video about a microcassette recorder. And this is not just any microcassette recorder, it's a Dictaphone Professional Series Microcassette Voice Processor. New in the original box. The original Dictaphone company was founded by Alexander Graham Bell, who, at least in North America, is credited with inventing the telephone. And then, in the early 1900s, he got involved with the Columbia Record Company, which was making a competitor to Edison's phonograph, which they called the graphophone. So when they introduced a machine for recording dictation, it made perfect sense to call it the dictaphone. And by the mid-20th century, dictaphone was pretty much a genericized trademark for any kind of dictation recording machine. But in 1979, Dictaphone got sold to Pitney Bowes, and then by the mid-90s, they ended up being sold back and forth to a bunch of different companies. They tried to get involved in voicemail systems and voice recognition software, but they never really took over the market. I think the trademark is now owned by Nuance Communications, who makes computer software. But this is from 1996. It was made in Japan. It was the model 3254. Includes batteries, that's unusual, cassette tape and carry case. Oh, here's some of the features. End of tape warning, voice activated recording, and electronic end of letter indexing. So let's open it up, take a look. I think this is the recorder itself. There we go. And here is the carrying case. Feels like vinyl. With a little zipper on it. So that's nice to have. Original warranty card. Going to Dictaphone Corporation in Melbourne, Florida. That's really wedged in there, but that's the original instructions, if I can get it out. There. In multiple languages. Dated January 1997. And here is the original tape, never opened or used. That is a 60-minute tape. And here is still those original batteries. Toshiba AAA batteries from 1997. And yeah, they're starting to leak, so I doubt these batteries are any good. Well, this one still has a little bit of a charge. Maybe it's putting out half a volt or something like that. And this one, the crustier one, is totally stone dead. So I got some new batteries. I got the blank tape. Got the recorder itself and instruction manual in case I need to refer to it. Put the new batteries in. And let's see, play, stop. Oh, you probably have to put a tape in order to play it. And it beeps because there's no tape in it. Unwrap this new tape, if I can figure out how to do it. They give you a string here. There we go. There is the new tape. I thought it was a clamshell like pretty much any other cassette or microcassette case, but no, this one opens weird. Opens like that. I never seen that before. And there is the microcassette. You can see it runs the other way compared to standard cassettes. It goes from the right to the left. It's on dictation. It's on the faster tape speed, 2.4 centimeters per second, which is half the speed of a standard cassette. So that's 15 sixteenths of an inch per second. And there's also the slower speed, which is 1.2 centimeters per second or 15 32nds of an inch per second. But I'll put it on the faster speed. Voice activated recording or Vox. I'll turn that off for now. Has a power switch and a 3 volt DC input. There's the tape counter, digital tape counter. Let's try Fast forwarding a little bit, you have to hold it. It doesn't stay down. And obviously there's nothing on the tape, so let's rewind to the beginning. And it beeps when you reach the end. And I'll make a recording.
This is a test of the Dictaphone Professional Series Microcassette Voice Processor, model 3254 from 1997. Making a quick test recording to see how this thing sounds. This is the faster recording speed of 2.4 centimeters per second. Now I'll stop and switch to the slower speed of 1.2 centimeters per second. Now recording at the slower speed of 1.2 centimeters per second, you should notice a decrease in the voice recording quality, although this will give you a longer recording time on the tape. So this concludes my first test of the Dictaphone microcassette recorder.
Well, you get the point.
It's interesting that it seemed to know when I reached the end of my recording and it automatically stopped and started beeping. So that may be the automatic index tone feature of this thing. I don't see a manual index tone button on it, unless maybe this button does that. Ah, I hear it making a buzzing noise when I push this button, so this must be the cue tone button, where when you rewind or fast forward and run across this part of the tape, where you push the button, you'll hear a beep indicating that it's the beginning or end of your recording.
So the way that index tone feature works is when you're recording, you push this button, it makes a tone on the tape, and then when you rewind the tape, it'll detect that tone, it'll sound the beep, it'll momentarily stop the rewinding to give you an opportunity to release the button and start playing at that moment. So you can use those index tones to mark the beginning and end of your recordings.
Tone button on it.
So you can see it momentarily stops whenever it comes across one of those index marks when it's rewinding. So you can let go and start playing at the beginning of that segment of your recording. A very nice feature to have if you're using this for its intended purpose of recording dictation. And also when you're playing and you hold down this button, it goes into fast play mode, which increases the speed of the tape, but not to such an extent that you can't understand what is being said. So if somebody's a slow talker and you just want to review what they said more quickly while still being able to understand them, you can hold down this button.
This thing.
I don't see a manual index tone button on it, unless
maybe this button does that.
And here's a test recording I made using the Vox feature.
I am now making a recording with the Vox feature turned on. What this feature does is it automatically detects when you start talking and it automatically starts recording, and then after a few seconds of silence it stops recording in order to avoid wasting tape recording long segments of silence. I had to look it up in the manual, but there's actually an adjustable sensitivity for the Vox feature using the volume control. The more you turn it up, the more sensitive it is to sounds. But at a lower volume setting, when you record with the Vox setting, you need to have a rather loud sound in order for it to start recording. The consequence of using the Vox feature, as you probably have already heard, is that it takes a little bit of time for the tape mechanism to start recording, so it tends to cut off the first word or first portion of what you're saying when you begin speaking.
You also saw that it has a counter for how many times it has detected that index tone on a tape. So it said letter 5, which means it's been keeping track, and so far I've put that index tone on the tape 5 times. And as you rewind, you'll see that number go down. And then when you reach the end of the tape, it says end. Also, I noticed there's no button to reset the tape counter, but whenever you eject the tape, it resets to 0. And another example of when it's helpful to read the manual is that I noticed this doesn't appear to have an external microphone jack. It has a telephone jack and an earphone jack. But then I read the manual, and it says to use an external microphone, you plug it into the telephone jack. So you can use the jack for either the telephone recording adapter, which I did not get with this, or a microphone. Unfortunately, this is not a standard 3.5mm jack, it's a 2.5mm jack. And in fact, I think the earphone jack is the same way, because I have this microphone here, standard cassette recorder microphone. It uses 3.5mm plug for the microphone and 2.5mm for the remote on-off switch. And if I try to plug this 3.5mm plug into this, doesn't work in either the telephone or earphone jack. The 2.5mm plug fits. And unfortunately, I don't have an adapter for this, and I don't have any microphones with a 2.5mm plug on them. So unfortunately, I will not be able to test either using an external microphone or connecting it directly to the earphone output, rather than playing it through the built-in speaker. This was definitely Dictaphone's attempt to lock you into using only their microphones and earphones rather than any generic ones.
Now I put the microphone sensitivity switch on the conference setting, which makes it more sensitive so it can pick up multiple people speaking in a room. Right now, I'm standing about 3 feet or 1 meter away from the recorder speaking in a normal voice. And now I'm about 6 feet away speaking in a slightly higher voice to see how good this thing picks up in conference mode.
So I've showed you most of what this thing can do. Just one more unique feature is that if you hold down this button while you're rewinding, you'll actually erase what you've recorded. So now if I hold down this button and put it in the rewind position, you can see it says Dell on the display and it's erasing what I recorded. Now if I play it again, we just hear hiss because it erased what I recorded. This is definitely one of the nicer microcassette recorders I've used. It's not necessarily the highest audio quality in either recording or playback, but for its intended purpose of recording dictation, it's certainly adequate, and it has a couple of nice features, including those index tones and this digital counter. And even though the casing is made of plastic rather than aluminum, like some of the higher quality microcassette recorders used, it still feels high quality. The controls have a nice layout and feel to them, ergonomic to operate, and overall nice quality microcassette recorder. So that's the Dictaphone Professional Series Microcassette Voice Processor. Funny sounding name, but a good quality machine.